The Ottoman Interregnum, which brought the Ottoman Empire to the brink of disintegration, constitutes one of the most important turning points in Ottoman history. This period of internal struggle and turmoil, in which the central state established by Yıldırım Bayezid with great difficulties, faced with danger of dissolving and disappearing. With the death of Yıldırım Bayezid after the Battle of Ankara, his sons named Süleyman, İsa, Musa, Mehmet, Mustafa and Kasım were left behind. Timur, who wanted to dismantle the Ottoman state, took the lands belonging to the Anatolian base from the Ottomans and returned them to their former owners, and shared the remaining parts among the sons of Bayezid. The oldest prince, Emir Süleyman, came to Bursa with his vizier Çandarlı Ali Paşa. From here, he took the state treasury, archives, his family, his younger brother Şehzade Kasım, and his sister Fatma Sultan Toguzelce Hisar. After staying here for a while, in February 1403, he went to Gallipoli and signed a treaty with the Byzantine Emperor Manuel. According to the treaty, Süleyman left some territories to the Byzantines. In addition to that, the tribute that Ottomans were receiving from the Byzantines was removed. He also left his younger brother Kasım and his sister Fatma Sultan as a hostage in Constantinople. After Süleyman declared his reign in Edirne, his younger brothers İsa and Musa started a struggle to dominate Bursa in Anatolia. İsa captured Bursa, later Timur freed Musa while returning to Samarkand. Musa defeated İsa and dominated Bursa. However, İsa returned and defeated Musa and recaptured the city. In 1404, Mehmet captured Amasya and Sivas as a vassal of Timur. Mehmet proposed to share Anatolia with his brother İsa, however İsa refused to call and he confronted his brother in Ulubat. There, Mehmet defeated İsa and declared his sovereignty. However, İsa managed to escape to Constantinople. In the meantime, İsa was sent to Edirne with the request of Süleyman. Süleyman supported İsa against Mehmet, whom he saw as a rival, and sent him back to Anatolia with a strong army. However, İsa was not successful in this. In 1406, İsa attacked his brother's domain yet again, but he was defeated and strangled by Mehmet's men. Upon hearing the defeat of İsa, Çandarlı went to Anatolia with a strong army and took Bursa. Following year, Süleyman advanced to Ankara, although he was defeated near Yenişehir Plain. In 1409, Karamanoğlu Mehmet Bey decided to send Musa to Balkans with a strong army. Musa appeared in the north and started move towards the Danube River. When Süleyman heard this, he was in panic and had to leave Anatolia. On June 15, 1410, the Battle of Kozmidion happened near Constantinople. It was a pyrrhic victory for Süleyman. Musa fled to Valachia. However, next year, Musa managed to capture the capital Edirne and Süleyman had to escape, but he was captured and strangled by Musa's men. Later, he started a war against the Byzantines. He retook the cities on the Black Sea and Thessaly regions, which his brother Süleyman had to left to the Byzantines. In 1411, he besieged Constantinople. However, his nephew Orhan Çelebi appeared in Rumelia with the support of Mehmet. Orhan's forces attacked Thessaly and managed to capture many castles. Musa had to partially lift his siege but managed to defeat his nephew. On 5th July 1430, forces of Mehmet and Musa came face to face in the Çamurlu field near Sofia. Musa lost the battle and he was captured wounded. He was executed with the order of Mehmet. Today, Mehmet is considered the second founder of the Ottoman Empire. But this was not the end. He will meet his forgotten brother Mustafa Çelebi. But that's another story.